Either way, when we look at all of those outbreaks, whether it be the salmonella, the hepatitis A, or the E. coli outbreaks, who did they most affect? Who got sick? Who died in those cases? Yeah, the elderly, the children, those are known as your highly susceptible populations. And this is actually going to be the first point where we're going to start filling in the blanks on those nice little course outlines if you do want to follow along. We actually have four highly susceptible populations. So we've already covered two of them. We've said we've got elderly and children. When it comes to children, it's actually classified as 4 years and younger, and that's because of their immune system development. For elderly, we don't put an age to it, and it's not because we don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. It's just because people's immune systems really age at very different rates. I could have somebody who's 70 years old and they have a healthier immune system than somebody who's 40 years old. But generally speaking, as we age, our immune systems are going to weaken. Pregnant women, and then we have immunocompromised. And immunocompromised means they already have a weakened or suppressed immune system. They're already sick. Maybe they have a disease that affects the immune system. They have AIDS or HIV. They're going through chemotherapy treatments. They've just had an organ transplant. What these groups mean is that they are at a greater risk of either becoming sick or possibly dying from being exposed to foodborne illnesses. And that's why, in the cases that we looked at, with the E. coli outbreak, there were 600 people that got sick, but the only deaths were small children, people who were from highly susceptible populations. The salmonella outbreak, 40 people got sick, but the only death was somebody who, again, was from highly susceptible. Now, it also could be a difference, though, between getting sick and not getting sick at all. I like to eat my burgers rare to medium rare, so they're absolutely undercooked. And there are plenty of times where I could go to a restaurant and order a burger rare, or I could cook a burger on the grill at home rare, and it does have E. coli in it. It does have this bacteria, but I don't get sick, because I have this good, healthy immune system that can fight that off, no big deal. Whereas if I shared that burger with a two-year-old, they could get very sick from eating that same burger. They could possibly die from eating that same burger that I had that didn't make me sick. So do things go wrong all the time? Yes. Have you ever been to a restaurant and probably gotten a piece of chicken that wasn't fully cooked? Yes, you probably have. So why aren't we getting sick every day from this? Because we do have these good, healthy immune systems that can fight that off. But that's the thing with highly susceptible populations that's scary, is you have these people coming in. If something goes wrong and you're serving that customer, it could cause very severe illness. They could possibly lose their life. This is also why highly susceptible populations are going to have some stricter regulations. So there are going to be some things that we talk about in the class today. I'm going to say everybody's allowed to do this except our highly susceptible populations.